Okay, let's look at part B of the same problem. So we have that PRST is PS times PT times PR given ST. So if we were to draw our little diagram for this one, it would be, well, we start with S, then we start with T. So we start with S and T. And from there, we get R given both of them. So given both of them, we have R. And we're interested in the two questions. Is S independent of T? And is S independent of T given R? So let's look at the first question. Well, just like in part A, if we want to compute P, S, if you want to compute whether S and T are independent, we have to look at the joint distribution and see whether we can write it as a product of the two individual distributions. So once again, how do we compute the joint distribution for these two? We just have to take what we start with and sum over every possible R. And if we plug in for PRST, I'll skip one step and just write these in. So this is PS times PT times P of R given ST. And if we look carefully at this, we can see that the sum only depends on R. So we're summing over things that depend on R. But neither of these first two terms has any R in them. So we can actually factor them outside the sum. So this becomes PS times PT times the sum over R of PR given ST. But here's the thing. No matter what S and T are, if we sum over every possible value of R of this guy is the probability distribution over R. Happens to be conditioned on S and T, but at heart it's really a probability distribution over R. If we sum over every possible R, then this is just going to give us 1, because all probability distributions have to sum to 1. So this entire term sums to 1. So that means that P of S and T is equal to PS times PT. And that's exactly the condition for independence. So in this case, they are independent. Now, what about conditional independence? Well, how do we get tests for conditional independence? We have to look at the distribution P ST given R. And see whether it factors as something, some stuff that depends on S, and some stuff that only depends on T. And if it does, then they're conditionally independent. So how do we get this conditional distribution from the joint? Again, we just have to divide by PR. So this is PS, PT, PR given ST. Divided by PR. And if we try to factor this, we'll see that we run into trouble when we get to this term right here. Because in general, this term is not going to factor. We don't know how S and T interact here, and there are no simplifications we can do to make this term go away. So here, S and T are not conditionally independent given R. So we've seen from the last two examples that sometimes we can have marginal independence without conditional independence. And from part A, that sometimes we can have conditional independence without marginal independence. So it's important to keep in mind that these two are not always the same thing, and knowing one doesn't necessarily tell you the other.